No, I've been looking for it. That's if there's anything that I'm really looking on the lookout for what it is what does home mean? And hopefully by the end of this trip, I'll be like, oh, now I've figured it out, because it's been 7 years since I wrote Call You Home and I still don't know what it really means. Yeah. Today is a big day. Today is Christmas and my birthday, because I'm going home. It'll be only the second time in 15 years that I'll be going back home. Going to Zimbabwe. Let's go, let's go! So we left when I was 8 years old. And I thought we were gonna come back next year. And we didn't come back. And now we'll finally be back together as a whole family, the four of us who left, you know, 18, 19, years ago, whatever it is. Yeah, it's insane. It's gonna be special. The purpose of this trip, I know where I'm from. I know where my roots are, but there's a difference between just knowing the name and really like knowing what it is to be from that place. And all of my knowledge of Zimbabwe and of, it's from when I was 8 years old. And I just wanted to update that. I wanted to go back and really understand some of the things that I maybe missed the first time. Now we're really here. Now I'm home. I'm just excited to be home. Yeah. Then when we landed, I suddenly had the flood of memories. You know, you see something you haven't seen in a long time and suddenly you go, oh shit, I remember this and that and that and that, things that you didn't remember a second before. I'm about to see my mom. We're gonna be in Zimbabwe for the first time together since we left. Since, yeah, 18, 19 years ago is gonna be the first time of us being back in Zimbabwe together.
Madness, baby.
Of course you have to wear that pretty dress. Of course you have to. It's the thing that makes me happiest and gives me the most grounding of like who I am whenever I don't know what that is.
Oh, I missed you, mommy. I missed you.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I missed you, mommy.
Why did it have to be this long?
I know. Come on in. Come on, guys. We're back together after 19, 20 years. No one can really say the number. Oh, don't cry now. Don't cry now. Don't cry. Don't cry.
It means a lot to me. I never saw this time coming. The family comes first and just being together. Wow. I can't believe this is after all these years. I'm meeting the boys. My husband has come home and back in Africa, back to the place where we walked away, gave our backs to so many years ago.
For me, it's actually very, very, don't sound emotional, but it's really emotional because, and I know at some point I think I'll cry because I never imagined this.
Living in the fast lane. Time is precious. I'm counting down the seconds. I can feel you on my skin.
I'm finally feeling so at one with all the sides of me. At some point in the last year, I really think it started with Carry You. I was at home and not knowing what I'm doing and what I'm going to come out with. And I started playing this little guitar. And I was like, ooh. That gives me all the right feelings. It sounded like the gospel choirs that I grew up hearing. It sounded like, we call them Maposto. I could hear all of those harmonies and everything. And it just, in that second, I was like, I know exactly what I'm doing. And so yeah, and from there, it just kind of, everything started to fall into place. Everything started to make sense. And so everything became exciting and colorful again. And I'm just sort of pushing further into that journey. The idea is to do a music video in the next 4 days. What I said to Marvin, my director, I called him up and I said, hey, listen, I'm just gonna fuck around. I'm just gonna have a good time. I know you're great with a camera. You just figure it out. I think we're going to a garage because there is a noise that is coming from underneath the car that I've not heard from cars before. It's a noise I've heard from many animals, but few cars. We've been driving for 3 minutes. We drove for 3 minutes, and then the car was like, that's enough.
We think it's this here. I know as much about fixing cars as I do about cooking. Nothing. I'm just looking at it, I'm like, that's a wheel. I'm gonna do some things that people do when they don't know. It might be a problem with the logo. I think the logo's upside down. That might cause some issues.
What I love and hate about Zimbabwe, or Zimbabweans, and it's about myself. I have this exact thing, is the chaos. You know, that's exactly who I am. I'm an absolute fucking mess.
Welcome back to Kelvin Cars, kelvincars.com. So we were missing the thing that makes the wheel become a wheel. And so now that's what we're trying to find. It's a little stressful, but to be honest, it's a good place to be stressed when you've got the sun and you know, there's a gorgeous tree right there. There's so much going on. And all of it feels like culture is the only word that I keep on thinking of. There are places maybe where I go to and I feel less connected to the culture. Everything is in its place and there's not enough randomness, you know? I keep on looking going, wait, what's that? You know? And I kind of love that. I feel at home in that a little bit.
I still don't know what happened with the tire, but we went to like 3 garages and eventually somebody fixed it. I don't know who, I don't know how, but they fixed it and we were up and going and I was like, okay, we have like an hour before sun sets. We need to get on this rooftop. I'm shooting the music video for Carry You, my latest, biggest, baddest, fattest, sexiest single. And we brought it home. Finally came home. I'm in Harare. I'm on a rooftop. I got my city behind me. I can finally say that. Hold on to me, darling. Your love is running low. Even when you're falling, I will carry you.
It's nervous because Kelvin is on the rooftop, really close to the edge, but it looked pretty cool. Yeah, but nervous.
Is this movable? Don't fall down. Nice.
You know what? It was a lot. It was a lot today. It was a lot going on. We flew in and we barely got packed. We haven't really eaten. Have we eaten it? No, we haven't eaten anything. We just came here and we just started shooting. And even with all of that, I feel like I'm on a beach in Hawaii. I feel relaxed as fuck. I feel so like calm. I don't know what it is, but yeah, that's how I feel right now. I'm in the right place. So this album has come together in the last 3 or 4 years, to be honest. It's been a long process. The album just kind of goes through so many different journeys. It goes through writing Cry a Little Less in London and on the underground. Then it goes to telling myself, I think I can produce, and producing Don't Let Me Go on my own. Then it goes to Jasmine, the song where I'm just like, okay, I want to write something that's even more from here, and writing this story about my mom and dad, one time when my dad nearly died, and then finishes off right here with Carry You. And that, in a sense, is the end of this chapter and the start of the next one. I'll be here with you till you're up again.
We're visiting Gogo, my grandma.
Di Gogo, ere?
I'm trying to define what home is, and I don't think it stays the same.
We are just arriving in Buhera. Honestly, I don't know what to expect.
I just hope that the world will accept him and the way he expresses himself.